Okay, friends, good morning. It's a very lovely Sunday morning, and I welcome you on behalf of Brand Club Ahmedabad for the second day of the fest. And we are going to start with a lovely presentation today. Now, I'll tell you one of the experiences which I had in my life. From the childhood, I've been with a girl who took care of my taste. Years passed, I traveled the journey of my life. I grew up from a kid to a man, but you know, she didn't age. She remained young and remained close to my heart. Yes, I'm talking of the lovely, utterly, butterly, delicious Amul girl with whom I'm sure we all are in love for more than 55 years. Today, we are excited to have Mr. Rahul Dakuna, the man who and his agency has dedicated the generation to keep our Amul girl young in our hearts and mind. Rahul has balanced advertising, theater, and writing over 35 years. We are lucky to have him today here. He started his advertising career in an agency held by great Kirsi Katrak called Fulcrum, teaming up with the art director partner Prashant Godbole. Later, they worked with Alec Padamse at Lintas. Together, Godbole and he created the campaign Hamara Bazaar for Bajaj Scooters, which won Best TV Commercial in 1989 and the Ad Club Awards. They also worked on campaigns for Park Avenue, Hong Kong Bank, and Hindustan Levers. This was followed by a stint at Contract India. He also joined Contract India, where they created campaigns for Philips Audio, Finolux Pipes and Cables, and Camlin, their pioneering black and white campaign, which you might have all observed. Feel the experience while you shop for Shopper Stop, won the agency, the Art Director Guild's Award, and the Best Print Campaign in New York in 1991. Since 1993, he has worked with Dakuna Communication. In 1995, he teamed up with writer Manish Zaveri and cartoonist Jayant Rane, who worked on Amul Butter topical campaigns. The campaign had entered, very interesting, the campaigns have entered the Guinness Book of Records for the longest running outdoor campaign from 1965 to 2019. One new Amul topical is created by the trio very second day on a variety of topics from cricket to Bollywood, from popular culture to politics. In 2015, Dakuna Communication and Film Production Company Final Cut won an Ad Club Abbey for their Amul film Mooch Nahi To Kuch Nahi, and a hair cutting salon, very popular brand. Creativity motivates Rahul. He is actively involved in theater. He has performed in esteemed festivals and stages across globe with famous artists like Tom Walter, Shehnaz Patel, Rajit Kapoor, Rahul Bose, Boman Irani, and late Sudhir Joshi, to name a few. Rahul is also a passionate writer. He wrote a column titled 2 Paisa Worth for Times of India from 1999 to 2009. Rahul writes a weekly column, which is humor-based, for Sunday Midday, titled Zara Hatke, having created the first fictional character, the cable TV technician Lobo Lobo. He plans to write his book, tentatively titled Mundane Stuff. So we at Brand Club are lucky, are blessed, you can say, to have Rahul with us today in the morning. And I would like Rahul to take the session ahead. Welcome, Rahul.
Thank you. So am I clear, guys? Am I clear?
Yeah.
So guys, good morning. Sanjay, thank you. For a moment when you said you were in love with a girl, I was wondering whether this would be another kind of presentation. Yeah. But that's for another day. Yeah. So listen, I think, guys, one of my reasons to be interested in presenting this campaign to all of you is my complete interest in young people. And I don't mean that from the standpoint of a kind of superior older man saying, oh, nice to know how young people think. But one thing I have realized is that to be in advertising, to be in communication, I mean, whether it's film, whether it's advertising, whether it's journalism, it's really the millennials, it's really the under 35s could really, I think, make a difference, will make a difference. And frankly, they're not necessarily the buying public always, but they're certainly the thinking, convincing audiences that marketers like myself need to think about. So I'm going to jump in straight away. And as Sanjay said, try and understand this campaign, which has been a 55-year-old campaign. So in essence, this is a campaign that has really become the toast of a nation. And it makes me happy that a campaign like this can, most campaigns that get created in 1965, perhaps die by 70, 75, 80. But this is a campaign that has lasted this long. And I wanted to share with you a little bit of history before we get down to what is the present. So some of you may or may not know this, but my father and his art director, Eustace Fernandez, created this campaign in 1964-65. Very briefly, there was no brief. There was just the fact that the great Dr. Kurian, who founded Amul, gave my father this account, which is Amul Butter account. And my father had the quite onerous task of trying to advertise a brand like butter, which is food, at a time when there was no media. There was no television, there was no press. There was only the outdoor medium. So he went to, basically my father went to Dr. Kurian with this idea of a young girl with a ponytail, with a polka dotted dress, making comments about the country. And this, I wanted to go into this slightly because you're all from Gujarat, and this is a man who, like many of us who sort of function on this earth, kind of are concerned about our own lives, our own income, our own standard of living. This is a man who came to Gujarat and set up a cooperative movement that has now encompassed, I can't even begin to share how many farmers, but he was also my dad's client. And my father told them, look, for us to run this campaign, you need to give us complete freedom. My father said something to Dr. Kurian. He said, if we are to do this campaign, I need you to give me a carte blanche freedom. If I go through the process of sharing the idea with you and then the sketch and then we will lose time. Because this was in 1965, what we today call moment marketing. So moment is everything. And if you lose a day, you've lost the topic. And so he said this actually to my father. He says, I realize how wise a decision it was to give complete freedom to the ad agency to do their job in a professional way. The Amul girl has given the brand just the image we have in mind, that of a precious, priceless product that the consumer could trust completely. So there were two things, ladies and gentlemen, that my father created. One was the butter girl. And the second was the slogan, utterly, butterly delicious. Now, I've often been asked on my father's behalf as to why a butter girl and not a butter boy. There is a butter boy, but I think all of us know that a butter girl, I mean, girls are just cuter than boys, right? I mean, look around you. I can't see anybody, but girls are always more fun, yeah. And the decision has actually worked quite in our favor because when this little girl says something about the nation, it's easily digested by everybody, whether it's film stars, whether it's politicians. And I'll come to it later, but we have, part of the new joy of social media is that we get responses from Karan Johar and Bachchan and, you know, the politicians appreciating what we do because never are we malicious. So guys, very importantly, I wanted to also treat this presentation as lessons that I have learned and wanted to share with all of you. I don't know how many of you want to be in advertising, how many of you are in advertising, but I thought this is a really important lesson, which is in the creation of an idea, the big idea, the long-term property is important. Too often, I think we create advertising which is for the short term. It's always tactical advertising. Clients will always tell you, nahi yaar, mera, my motorcycle has got 15 cylinders and 25 wheels and 18 gears. Nobody wants to know. People want to know, okay, what are you selling? I can go to the showroom and buy the bike. So what is it about your brand that is special and not produced in the factory? So this was, as I said, the choice that my father made, which is that the outdoor was going to be the medium of instruction. And this, my friends, was the first one. Give us this day our daily bread. You can see that the little butter girl, in those days, slightly not, she didn't, there were no gyms then. No? So she's not as fit as she would be today. But she's praying and looking at the butter. At this stage, it was still a campaign that was slightly butter specific. But within a month, Dad realized that topical campaigns, events, festivals would be quite interesting. But always tying back to the butter. So this was in Bombay when the first horse racing season had started. He had a campaign which said Thoroughbred. So part of what makes this campaign enjoyable for me, frankly, and for my predecessors before me, is that Dr. Kurian in those years, Dr. Sodhi, Mr. Jayant Mehta, and Mr. Kishore Jhala, as recently as now, still don't ask me to show them the creative for approval. Dr. Kurian said a very funny thing to my father in those years. He told my dad, he said, Sylvester, if you want freedom, then don't get us into trouble. If you get us into trouble, then it's your problem. What has finally been shown is that they have our back. Right at the end of the presentation, I'm going to show you a couple of controversial ads we got into and how they helped us. So guys, some advertising facts. In 75, we did one topical a month. In 95, one topical a week. 2005, two topicals a week. And 2017 onwards, we averaged between 4 and 5. And I guess you're asking how it's possible. And that is because of the advent of social media. Social media, as I'll explain later, is a whole other world in itself. So the weekly schedule of topics is planned on Mondays. Guys, yeah, it's planned on Mondays. So what Manish, Jayant and I do every, frankly, Sunday night is to plan the weekly roadmap. So we look at, let us say, 5 topics. If we just take this week, okay, we look to see what film is launching on OTT. So will it be a popular film? Will it be a Bachchan film? Will it be an Ayushman film? How will it do? We look at politics. So what has happened in politics? Is something interesting happening in politics, Indian politics, world politics? We look at cricket. So obviously, Ajinkya's victory, India's victory, but Ajinkya, the captain, was an issue. Is the fact that Rohit Sharma and company went out to eat and were quarantined, is that topical enough? So it's a question of putting down the what we call the dhobi list of all the campaign ideas that we could have. And then my job becomes interesting where, because we've got 5 days ahead of us to decide what topic should be executed on Monday, and what topic should be executed on Friday? Because every topic we do goes up on social media. So it's not like in the old days where somebody would go up on a scaffolding and paint it, and that would take 5 days. So the topic was already dead by then, which is why my father's time did 2 topics a week, because it took time for it to happen. Here, Jayant just does the sketch and it's on. The next day it's changed. So social media and technology have helped us to be quick changing. So the newspaper or e-paper, as we call it, gives me the topic. But where social media has been the game changer for me personally and the team is that it has allowed, the social media gives me the trend. So time is of the essence, from topic finalization to headline to detailed hand-drawn illustration, all to be completed in just a few years. And I call it a 25/7 exercise because I can never go on holiday. The fact remains that I have to think about this campaign 25/7. So where are we today? We need to cut across boundaries and appeal to varied audiences. Attention spans have lessened. Young people tend to want to move to the next moment. Very often, India is not a nation by itself in a holistic way anymore. South India's got its issues, North India's got its issues, Bombay has got its issues within South Bombay, North Bombay. Often topicals are created only for social media. At any given point in time, different topicals across the nation are created. Even within Mumbai, 2 to 3 topicals are displayed simultaneously. So in principle, Amul reflects India and India reflects Amul. Lesson 2, there are 5 Indias in India. There is Mumbai. So topicals are done only for the city. So when Bombay became Mumbai, we said bye-bye to Bombay. When BT station became Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminal, we said Victoria terminated. When the private cabs, Uber and Ola, started to take away the black and the yellow and black taxi, we said Kali Pili ka jhagda chhodo. Now this is interesting because Kali Pili is such a Bombay term. This topic would not go anywhere but in Bombay because nobody would know what Kali Pili means. Kali Pili rest of the country means black and yellow, but to this means don't. For no reason, why take up a fight? Clubs, club culture, Bombay Jamkhana. When there was a politician who wanted membership, and the club said no, it got into a huge problem. And that is specific to South Bombay. So this was only released in South Bombay. The band U2 came to Bombay, so where the streets have one name. So we punned on the song where the streets have no name. So we said where the streets have one name. So the baseline, if you notice, always sums up the topic with a food. So have with Bono Maska. So Bono is food and Bono was the name of the musician. The beautiful Parsi community is dying. There are numbers that are getting less and less. So there was a Geo Parsi campaign. So we said Kao Parsi, Pio Parsi, Geo Parsi. When the yellow and the Kali Pili finally said goodbye, we said Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna. So this is what's interesting is, Manish, when we discuss the campaign, we try to draw in from Hindi film, from Sanskrit, from epics, from Gulzar's poetry. We always mix it up. So it comes out in a language that the average Indian appreciates. And when the bus tickets were lessened. Second, very important audience is Hindi belt. Politics becomes a hugely important thing. So we take gentle little jibes at all the various cast of characters, because each one of them is a character in himself. So when Akhilesh got into power, we said Samaj Worthy Party. When the great Lalu Prasad Yadav first went to jail, we said fodder of the nation. And we said Scamul. First time we played around with the name. This is when they all came together. So JDU, Judwa Bhai. So JDU is played with. Jab tak bread mein Amul rahega. Bihar ki jeet. We're playing around with Bihar and Har. A partnership with bread. So you're playing with Patna and Patna. When young Jyoti left the Congress and went to the BJP, we punned on Hath, as in the Congress Hath. They said, Hath se nikal gaya. The East, as they now prepare to go into election, is a whole other audience, where Mamata Didi becomes a really integral part of the whole East. So again, we took the famous Vishal Bhadwaj song, Didi Jalele, and made it Didi Jalele. Ada, poor condition. Well, has had a small cardiac arrest last night. He's a vital part of. So this was when he had just taken over the BCCI. He said butter created completely in India. So BCCI. This is the most complex part of India, I feel, because I'm calling it the South, but it's really four very, very different states. Hyderabad speaks Hindi, Kerala and Kerala doesn't speak Hindi, sorry. Andhra Pradesh speaks Hindi, Kerala and Madras, Chennai do not. So it's very, very interesting that they don't appreciate Bollywood either. So it's how we target. So when Telangana, Andhra Pradesh was divided, we called it Adha Pradesh. The great Jayalalitha, now the erstwhile, was vital to Chennai's progress. And finally, my friend, social media. This is why I said about changing the game is that Sanjay made an interesting point about how do you create advertising for a hoarding? And one of the key things is keep the message tight because the motorist or the passerby has got literally 2 minutes to pass your hoarding. So it's vital that you keep your message tight. The same principle, my friends, works with social media too, because most of you who are looking at your news on handsets, if it's not interesting, you're going to scroll down in 2 minutes. Yeah. So the principle works the same, that your audience, you have for 2 minutes max. So social media is filled with challenges. So we said, why not the butter pack challenge? But you have to kick off the cap of the bottle. So we said, why not associate ourselves with that? This again made no sense to me about the 10-year challenge. How did you look 10 years ago? How did you look in 2019? The butter girl has looked the same for 55 years. So for us, there's no challenge. Women were asked to wear saris. Game of Thrones, perhaps the most popular foreign TV show. And finally, emojis. Waha emoticon hai tera. So in summation, I would say, don't assume that the country is one in terms of language and interests. Very often when we create a campaign, too many marketers feel that one campaign is okay for the whole country. One size fits all. That is really not true. Lesson three is the brand consumer, the millennial, wants a brand conversation. This is a really, really important one because audiences today don't want to be spoken to, be spoken down to, and speak where they're not given a chance to answer. They want to converse. The consumer does not want anymore to be a passive participant. So how do you keep your brand fresh and relevant is vital, because the consumer has no patience, has many passions and passing fancies, which is why we change topicals at the rate of one every 2 days. Because we also realize now that a topical that lasts for 5 days has got a certain fatigue factor. So I have shepherded this campaign for 28 over 55 years. But in the recent past, it's been a roller coaster ride of an India that's been a Pandora's box, frankly. Crash crises, crazy dictators, cricket scandals, catastrophes, celebrityhood, cinema, both Hollywood and Bollywood, coronaviruses and China invasions. As you can see, are some of the most interesting issues that we have. So the Amul girl has been the nation's cheerleader, the conscience, the commentator, the critic, celebrity watcher, caricaturist. So she takes on many roles, my friends. She's somebody who is pretty much, I would still say, the conscience of the nation. So over the years, we have explored and commented on various themes. Obviously, politics has always been a favorite of ours. So Indian politics, I wanted to share this one with you. This is the first real political hoarding we did in 95. When Sonia Gandhi was trying to choose between Narasimha Rao and VP Singh. And we said, Party, Patni, or Go. riffing on a very, very popular film called Party Patni Arvo. Pati Patni Arvo, sorry. When the BJP first came in, Bhajabhai, I wanted to put this in because this was a very specific topic that we had done when the Premier of China came to Gujarat. So instead of India, we said Undia. And the Amul girl, as you can see, dresses up in costumes that are... So whenever we feel it's interesting, we've made her regional now. So for a Bengali topical, she can become Bengali. For a South Indian topical, she can be dressed in a South Indian way. And the Gujarati sari. When Obama came to town, Badi Badi Vaatein and Bread Butter Bromance. When the president, the prime minister of Israel came, he said, Shalom Namaste. Again, this is interesting because we're punning on the film Salam Namaste. When Sri Kejriwal won in Delhi for the first time, clean sweep. These jets have always been a topic of much interest to us. And the first time that the deal was made, we asked the question, will it be pass or Rafael? This topic, my friends, I wanted to share with you because this was one of the fastest hoardings we've ever done, which is where you realize social media and speed is so important. At 3 o'clock, I was driving to the suburbs and it was all over the news that Rahul Gandhi had hugged Narendra Modi ji in parliament. And it was perhaps the most trending gesture. So at 3 o'clock, I briefed Manish and Chandrane. And by 6 o'clock, this was out. And it was quite a... So the beauty about hoardings sometimes is you're combining two gestures. If you remember that incident, first he hugged him, then when he was walking back, he winked at his people. We combined the two. So this makes the topical even funnier. And Amul hugs Bread daily. So don't have to say much about this lovely lady. As she kept changing or kept... They kept making her head various ministries. So Sanskriti Irani. International affairs. So when China moved out of Hong Kong, we said Hong Kong, the gentleman in question kept us amused during the coronavirus. This is when he pulled money out from the WHO. So we said playing Hututu. This is when Joe Biden won the presidency. So it was a very closely fought. So this allows us to sometimes also pun using the person's name. And why this was in hoarding I liked a lot was that it allowed us to pun on Biden and biting. Breakfast and Brexit. This was China and USA and constant trade issues. So tarif karun kya iski? When Gaddafi was finally removed from Egypt, sorry, from Libya. Guys, there's some banging going on. Can you just look into it, please? There's a constant banging behind me. Yeah? Just look into it, please. Yeah. So no mafi for Gaddafi when in Libya he was finally removed. This is my favorite because Bollywood is always, especially now with social media being so popular the way it is. Karan Johar very famously, every time a film is featured on our hoardings, whether it's his own film or somebody else's film, he always says Amul validation. So one of my favorites, when Lagan was released, it allowed Lagan and Lagana to be used quite nicely. So Amul Lagana upon every slice in India. The one and only Bhai, so Swad se Swagat. Bachchan Saab is always been a favorite of ours because his character, his persona, the stuff that the man does has always been a... And he's had a good relationship with Amul. You know, I interviewed him once and he said, you know, I always look to see whether Amul has covered one of my films. And I know if you've not, because I know that either you will cover the film if it's very good or very bad. And he says, I know that sometimes you really pan my films, but I know for myself that this film is not going to do well. So, Vicky Donner, Amul, donate generously. So once again, Bhai's film, Loved Across Borders. So once again, Battamiz Dil allows a beautiful, we always love it when either a song or a film gives us the pun within the name itself. So Battamiz Dil became Battamiz Dil for Jawani and Diwani. Many years ago, the great M.F. Hussain had a obsession with Madhuri Dixit. So this gave us a great line, which is heroin addiction and Amul Fida on you. This is India's entry for the Oscars this year. So Amul Jali Good. Why I put this up was interesting because we had done this film for the movie PK. So we said, Kaan PK Jana? The frightening thing about social media today is that everything is available on the internet. And some really clever guy, when poor Amir was made that comment about not feeling safe in India, he found this hoarding in the archives and put it up and said Amul's response to Amir's comment. Just imagine, this was the Kaan PK hoarding was done in 2000 and whatever that year was. And this comment that he made happened 2 years later. And we had to go out there and say, look, guys, we didn't do this hoarding. I mean, we did it, but for the movie, we didn't do it to, we're not malicious. We would not tell Amir to leave the country. But it is beautiful in many ways because Amul has created this idea of a brand conversation where people can say what they feel. They send in their ideas. They can pan us, which is fair enough. They can praise us. And it's part of my job is to negotiate the, I mean, this lady is not at all prone to controversy and she's over prone. So this was actually very early when the first time she got into a controversy, we said Kangana never runs out of controversy. As you can see, Aishwarya and I think this was Priyanka, and they're constantly wearing the gowns on the red carpet. So punning on a favorite movie and song. Cricket will always be a favorite. And I think what has also made me happy was that till the IPL kicked in, cricket was really something that mostly men enjoyed. The IPL has created a situation where women also have begun to enjoy the sport. And that makes my job interesting because I don't really like to do hoardings and only men are enjoying it. So in 96, when Sachin was the only man playing well, we said 10 do, 10 don't. When Don Bradman compared Sachin to himself, we said dono Bradman. When Sachin retired. So you can see Sachin was also a favorite of ours because he so beautifully played like a single hand for India. So when he retired, we said India retires hurt. Master batter. When this is one of my favorites, actually, when Shoaib Akhtar in his book tried to knock Sachin and say, look, he was scared of my bowling. We said he used to throw then, now he's still throwing. When Dhoni won the World Cup. So Dhoni also, so I think all these icons have been great favorites of Amul. Kap hai toh ap hai, when he hit the winning run in 2011. Anhoni ko Dhoni kar de. When Dhoni retired from the sport, oh Mahi, oh Rahi. Again, one of my favorites where Harbhajan slapped Srisant. So we said Pav Bhaji. So this is the kind of hoarding I enjoy greatly because it allows for the food to be talked about both in the headline and in the baseline. So Pav Bhaji is a food item and slap it on is a food action. The famous super overs that have become a part of the T20 format, it's super over bread. And this is one of the recent ones we did when my favorite Ajinkya Rahane led us to victory. So Melbourne again, Ajinkya Makkhan. Patriotism has always been something very, very important to us as a brand, because Amul is really a national brand. It's really a brand that sides with India through its difficulties. And people, I think, look forward, people, government, armed forces, look forward to what will the Amul response be. So many years ago in Uttar Pradesh, when there was a landslide, the army moved in and really saved and helped people to safety. So Army Yogi, in good hands. Uri, the great battle of Uri, so surgical strikes. Amul packs a punch. So this is again Bharat Mata, when soldiers die fighting for us. When women get noticed in situations that they wouldn't have 30 years ago, we always acknowledge it, an officer and a gentlewoman. Many years ago, this was one of my favorites, when PM Vajpayee said, pack up and leave. So pack and park have always allowed us that fun. This is perhaps one of the most powerful hoardings we did when the terrorist attacked the Taj in 2008. And the politicians at that time really didn't do anything to help. And we asked a really tough question. We said, will the real terrorists please stand up? And this is a good example of a client like Amul really backing us, because this is quite a strong statement. You know, you're telling, you've done it in black and white. You have the army protecting an army man and protecting a politician. And you're saying, will the real terrorists, which is the politicians, please stand up? So it takes courage. I mean, and sometimes today I wonder whether I would do the same kind of hoarding. Do I have the courage to still do it? But we did this in 2008. When the gentleman responsible for the devastation in Bombay was finally being hanged, Kasab, we had a statement for that as well. The recent, again, the Chinese attack on us, so Matubhumi. When Air India got the first bunch of COVID victims out from China, Indians from China to here. So again, the pun on the Hindi movie Chini Kam, so Chini being the Chinese, so Chini Kam Karo. This was when the young little baby girl was raped. First time we showed the Amul girl crying. And this was an incredible moment for us, because it's true, because I take these things for granted, but to show the Amul girl crying caused such a national, I don't know how to use the word, people said this is the first time you've seen the Amul girl crying, because, and for the girl to cry when she's normally been laughing was a hell of a statement to make. Our response to Nirbhay, perhaps this will go down as one of our most popular ads, because today life is not just about the hoarding, but it's about life that happens outside the hoarding. So when we told the Chinese to leave, can you believe that Twitter, I don't know if you know about it, but Twitter actually took our hoarding off the Twitter handle. And obviously pressure from the Chinese, and we actually threatened them. And the topical was put back. But it shows you, at least it made me feel good that we really are making an impact at quite a national level, and an international level in this case. When all the various apps, Chinese apps, were being banned in the country, TikTok being the first one, we said, stick with the stock being Amul. And WeChat was the other app that was also thrown out of India. So we said, WeChat over tea. All of us have been through nine months of this. How did we tackle this? Very early on, when we said wash hands, we said better safe than sorry instead of safe than sorry. As we are all, our lives have been saved by Zoom. So co-video conferencing, make your test pass Zoom. I don't know about Gujarat, but in Bombay, they were dividing the city into various zones. Green zone was a safe zone, red zone was a very unsafe zone. So we said, there are many zones, but there's a yellow zone, which is Amul. PM Modi had asked us, I think it was his second address to the nation, where he said, I think it was at a certain time, he said 9 o'clock, everybody light a light. So we advertised it and said, do the light thing, but the off button on. I think self-reliance is something that he's been talking about for a long time. Yeah. So we're telling the housewife, make yourself. And also Panim with Master Chef and all the food shows that we've been doing. Bang the Bartans was his, I think his first address to the nation. This was a shout out to the MBBS workers who were just, even at that early stage, we didn't know much about the virus. They were out there risking themselves. So we said, MBBS, Makan Bole, Bahut Shukriya. You may have noticed this, but when somebody of some significant passes away, we do a black and white tribute to him. And this, frankly, this year has been the worst year in terms of this, where we lost so many great people, so many celebrities, so many stars. Jagdeep, Irfan, of course, started the whole terrible trend where he passed away just around the time the pandemic hit. Rishi Kapoor, I think they passed away in the same week, actually. We had these two back-to-back deaths. The great Saroj Khan, from the ABC to the Ek Do Teen of dance. Obviously, this was perhaps the most significant of all the deaths. Not Sushant's fault, but it just became such a national event. And so we've taken a line from his movie, Kai Poche. Our favorite, Maradona. His famous act of the hand of God, we made at the foot of God. James Bond, A Diamond is Forever. And finally, I wanted to take you gentlemen and ladies through two controversies that we went through. And I'll take you through them because they're quite humorous. Obviously, there are many more controversies that we go through now, but those are easier to handle because social media is good. Somebody writes in something, they're upset about something, we talk about it and it's over. But this one in 2009 was particularly interesting and funny because the mighty company Satyam guys, 7,000 crores in 2009 was a lot of money, right? So they got really upset, these guys. They sent us a letter saying, Dear Amul, if you don't withdraw this hoarding and say sorry to us, we will ask all our employees to stop using Amul. And I found that so sweet and funny because this is a company that is scammed 7,000 crores. Cross, and you write a letter to us, handwritten letter. So traditionally we've never said sorry, but the hoarding had changed in any case. But I found it very funny that finally, when it comes down to it, they were upset that we had said Satyam Sharam Scandalam. Very funny. And finally, my most favorite moment from all my years in Amul. And that was involving my beloved client, Dr. Kurian. So all of you obviously have heard of Jagmohan Dalmia, the erstwhile head of the BCCI. So back in, I think it was 98, there was some corrupt practices that the BCCI was indulging in. Guys, just remember, I was many, many years younger, many, many years more courageous. And in those years, I didn't really think, you know, when you're younger, like you guys, you tend to be fearless. So we went for it. We said, instead of dal mein kuch kala hai, we said dal mein kuch kala hai. And we said, maska khao, paisa nahi. And more importantly, there was no social media at that time. So we actually put up this hoarding in Calcutta and we had one hoarding outside his office. And he saw this hoarding on his return from somewhere. And he was so angry that he made one fatal mistake. He wanted to obviously take legal action. But instead of taking Amul to court or taking us to court, he made the fatal mistake of taking Dr. Kurian to court. And he, defamation, huge amount of money and all of that. And I'll never forget this. One morning, just after this had happened, my phone rang and it was Dr. Kurian. And he said, "Hello, this is Dr. Kurian." I said, "Yeah, I know. Hi." He said, "I believe there is some gentleman called something, Dalmia something, who has taken me to court. What is this about?" I said, "Look, you know, we did this hoarding, Dalmia Kuch Kala Hai. It shows Dalmia with in the pose of the three monkeys, you know, see no evil, hear no evil." And he said, "So what are you planning to do?" So I said, "Dr. K, what would you have me do? Because I can pull the hoarding down. We can have an apology." He said, no, my dear boy, don't do all that. "What I want you to do is you take down this hoarding. That's fine. But add a fourth monkey. And that monkey should be covering his private parts." And I remember thinking to myself, man, this is what we call courage. Yeah. This is, because if you're going to do a campaign like this, then you're going to have to have issues. And he just said, okay. And as it happens, the Indian system is such that the court case went away. But this is the kind of controversies that this, because see, this campaign is really top of mind, right? It's really something that's commenting on issues every day. It reflects what India's feeling. And sometimes India doesn't feel positively about something and they look to us to either get into an argument with or sue us or, you know. But this particular one was outstanding because it was really a one-on-one confrontation between two very powerful men. And we realized who was the actually powerful man. Yeah. So yeah, thank you, my friends. That is the story of 55 years. I've tried to encapsulate that into, I don't know how long, 45 minutes. So yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much. And you know, it's a lovely morning, Sunday morning with your breakfast, having Amul talks with us. And you know, your lot of good compliments are coming up. Like Dr. Chandramouli Pathak writes that amazing ideas, creativity to connect, impressed, rare opportunity to learn from such legends and experts. And Amrita writes, amazing ideas implemented. Thank you for such an insightful session. Now, we have few questions also, which are very interesting in nature.
Yeah.
Raul, if you permit me, can I throw those questions to you?
Please.
Yeah. Somebody wrote, do you think, this was Natasha Dastur from GLS. She writes, she says that, do you think that focusing on such day-to-day life topics makes a better difference to the audience than talking about the product itself?
My question is what to talk about the product. You know, the decision made many years ago was finally a butter is a butter is a butter, no? There's only so much that you can say about the butter. And just to let Natasha know that the outdoor campaign does this job, which is the what we call the topical campaign, is that the butter girl is commenting on events. But we have a whole separate campaign for Amul Butter, where the little girl and models and we have food experts shooting. So that's a separate campaign. Amul Butter, that job does its own job. This one is purely for the commenting of issues and topics.
Yeah. Good. There's a question from Shikha. She says that, sir, how do you manage to stay away from controversies? Amul has always been bold brand and talks about various issues. As you rightly give few examples.
I don't know. I think I will say one thing, that in the last 5 to 7 years, I have stayed away from some topics completely. I don't enter into religion at all, in any form. Not Christianity, not Hinduism, not Islam, not prophets, not godmen. We just stay away from religion, because religion is really something that is no win. There's no humor in it. There's no point to be made. It's too dicey an issue. It's entered into politics. So about 10 years ago, I remember we did a hoarding on Chandraswamy, who was a Swami during the Congress regime. And I had the guts to say Chandra's lying. And I got away with it. I could not believe it. When I think about it now, I say to myself, what was I thinking? Today, I wouldn't even go there. Today, I would not enter into an area of such controversy, because it doesn't. And see, my big thing, which is I never forget, I'm not a cartoonist and I'm not a caricaturist and I'm not a satirist. I'm still selling a brand. I don't want a situation today where I do a topical because I think it's really funny, and some mad person pulls my hoarding down or you know, goes in and ransacks a general store selling Amul. So that is a very, very balancing act I have to do, of making sure that the brand is never affected.
Okay, great. This is one more question from a social media expert who says, how do you think the ad campaigns creating process have changed from TV to social media? What things are a social media advertiser should keep in mind while crafting an ad for social media?
I don't know.
Yeah. So how do you think the campaign process have changed from television to social media?
So it's not moved from television. Is still a very, very, to me, the most powerful way of getting a message across is still television, I feel. So digital will never replace television. The only thing that interests me is why I talk about young people being the most interesting and most challenging audience is that today's millennials don't watch television. So where do you catch them and how do you catch them? Which is why digital media comes into the picture. But I still think to catch them with movies and small films and celebrities is still the way to go. I don't think a static medium like digital media can still replace the moving cinematic medium. But the principle still stays the same. You have to talk to people in the language they understand. You cannot be a 58-year-old man talking to a 25-year-old person in the language you think they understand. Which is where I think research becomes really important. Is that what is the 20-year-old thinking about? Because we tend to say, oh, all young people. Young people, Sanjay, between 16 and 19, there's a difference.
It said that it's not now a generation gap, it's a yearly gap.
I don't know what gap, man, but it's like a crazy gap.
Yeah. So for my academic knowledge and curiosity, I just wanted to know what would be the number of hoardings you take in any time in any month in the country? How many hoardings?
You mean, so I'll tell you how many we do. We average about 50 in a month.
Okay.
So that's
a number of hoardings in the
sites. About, guess, take a guess.
2000?
I wish, no.
Across the country?
No, man. It's about 500.
Achha. In the prime locations.
Some are prime. Some cities don't have. Because I look at a country like India, na, Sanjay. It's like we used to think that metros and class one towns today. A class two town has got a huge population. Yeah. A place like Pune, when we first started, had one site. Pune has become a mini city. Yeah. You know.
So my one more question which I have is that what is your message to the people, the young people who are into advertising or who want to enter into advertising? What is your lesson? Because you've been in this industry for long. So you might be seeing a great change between what we had in our time and what the new generation is coming up with. So what is your message to them?
You know, I really feel that because my first message would be don't get into it. Okay. We'll get into it. But my second message is, it's a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant business to be in. Brilliant. Because it really and truly gets you to... So my advice, Sanjay, would be, you can learn about advertising once you enter advertising. You don't have to really know, like in MBA, I think you need to understand, you know, management before you get into an ad agency or whatever. But in advertising, I feel if you're intelligent, if you are a good listener, if you have got patience, because the point is that clients are difficult people, and they're not being difficult. They're being, because they're worried about selling their brand. So too many creative people, I feel, I used to be like that when I was young. Hey, the client has bounced my campaign, whatever. But I realize now, he's spending 100 crores on this campaign, man. I'm just seeing it as a film. He's seeing it as will it sell my product or not? So it's about persuasion. It's about, you have to make yourself aware of what's happening around you. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm going to say this to young people. One of the downsides of you guys is you think that because you have the internet available to you, you know everything. And I mean that well, because we had to struggle to get information, to go to the library and bloody hell, God knows what. Today it's at your fingertips. But you can't replace hard work here. Yeah. You cannot. The same rigor, some great photographer once said, you need to spend 1,000 hours in any field you want to excel in. To be in advertising, you need to study it. Yeah? You have to study what are good commercials, you know, study what makes a good press ad. And most importantly, study internet advertising, because digital has just come in, frankly. What does moment marketing mean? What does digital marketing mean? How do you reach out? What is the best way? Our website's still a good way to go. You know, there's a whole, because what we didn't have to worry about in the 70s, 80s and 90s, we didn't have to worry about technology because there was no technology, right? Today, it is vital because technology is everything. And the use of it becomes very important.
No. Yeah, exactly. So before we sign off, there is one more interesting question which just popped in. The question is that how do you monitor the response of your campaign, internet. Outdoor campaign, because?
Internet, because it's a, so what is interesting actually is that 20 years ago, I had no means of monitoring it.
Yeah.
Today, you can tell from topical to topical, how many likes, how many comments, it tells you in 2 minutes. Of course, it's a thumbnail. It doesn't tell you the whole nation, but it certainly tells you that a Bollywood based topical will have many more likes than a political. So I've downed my politics because kids are not keen on politics. They feel all politicians are corrupt. So they're not really interested in, but they're interested in one of the big things is popular culture is huge. Internet issues are huge because kids want to know what's happening in, they want to know what's happening in their heads. And they want to know that their parents, establishments, governments, corporations are thinking about them.
Yeah.
I truly want to get into the head. If I could do that, find a way of getting into the head of 19-year-olds and really understand what they're thinking. That would be really interesting. Yeah.
Okay, great, great. So we are really delighted and we are really grateful to you to, you know, spare your very valuable time to us, to Brand Club Ahmedabad, and speaking to the audience of Gujarat and sharing your experiences for so many years and keeping the girl alive in our minds and hearts. On behalf of Brand Club Ahmedabad, I once again thank you. And I take a promise that you will keep visiting us, keep enriching us with your knowledge. And from on behalf of all the audience, I thank you again on this lovely Sunday and on the brand.
So just one thing I wanted to tell you.
Yeah.
I'm half Gujarati.
Oh,
My mother's Gujarati. She's a Patel. And my grandfather was the ex-finance minister, H.M. Patel, of So I've got a strong Gujarati side. So Ahmedabad and Anand and Baroda for me are very special. Yeah. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you all. Yeah.